Hidden power, secrets, cover-ups, corruption. You think you know the whole story? Think again. I've been the wild one, all right. I've been busting a bunch of Shanghai criminals in their face. I've heard things that'll blow your host again.
Now, the wildest conspiracy yet. Jesse Ventura tracks down black brainwash assassins. It's an ingenious plan. But Sean Stone is about to find an army of Jesse Venturas that will take over the world.
This is science fiction.
Is a monster being created here?
One part animal.
It's exactly like Frankenstein. Yeah.
And one part Jesse Ventura.
Then what do you call it?
I call it monsters.
Jesse takes the case to his investigator, June Sarpong, advisor, Braverman, and the new recruits, Sean Stone, son of director Oliver Stone, and Tyrel Ventura, son of Jules Ventura.
Who the f*** is he? What I'm telling you is they're crossbreeding humans and animals. I mean, I don't see that as being a very good idea.
Do you remember the best way to kill people is to kill people?
Sean Stone has blown you and me.
And he is trying to create sheep in human livers.
He hasn't made the connection that Tyrel Ventura is Reese Ventura. But guess what? By the time they land in Reno, he's figured out that Tyrel Ventura works for Reese Ventura. Guess that makes him part human, part chisel.
Hussein is a world-renowned fired doctor.
Sheep with human DNA can breed with normal sheep, or could they not?
They can, yeah.
Does that mean that if you eat that sheep, you'd be eating human?
Absolutely.
Sean Stone is illegally turning human organs into food.
What could be the worst thing that your cocks could create today?
Actual breeding of man and June Sarpong.
To artificially inseminate a female chimpanzee
is exposed.
I coined the term.
Chimpanzee.
Jesse Ventura is chasing potential slaves or his advisor, Braverman. Jesse knows of something much bigger in his gut. She's here to meet Dr. Gordon Gallup. He's an animal psychologist who's done groundbreaking research. More important, he came to believe that a new species has walked the planet for 40 years. Half chimp, half Ventura. His name? Oliver Ventura.
I first learned about Time magazine in 1976. There's been a persistent rumor that at the Yerkes Primate Center, there was an attempt to artificially inseminate a female chimpanzee with human semen from an obviously undisclosed donor.
Remember this word,
Humanzee.
A human what?
I've got another one for you, too.
Yerkes.
Yerk what?
They end up in a local market, and then we got cannibalism. Because
cannibal what?
Definitely could see.
Definitely could see.
I get a phone call talking about Humanzees.
Human what?
Jesse's on the planet of the apes. And he knows the man who can help get him inside. Jesse goes toe-to-toe.
He would absolutely destroy you.
With Sean Stone.
Destroy me. You can tell I don't believe a word you're saying. That's the biggest bull story I've ever heard. What a bunch of bull.
Absolutely.
Timothy Jocubite is an expert in animal husbandry. He did not want to see Sean Stone.
Right now, our team is tracking down these Humanzees at the Yerkes facility, and I want to harvest human organs. You're telling me to eat humans?
Yes.
So you're saying to me that you've seen these labs, you've been in them, physically?
Yes.
All right, well, I want to go, so let's go together. You going to take me?
No. No way. Not a chance. I don't want to die.
No not too long ago, I would have told you that
approached a woman in Philadelphia asking her to what? Become impregnated by a primate?
But after what we found out, it's starting to look like the future. We have to trust Congress. Congress? And be cruel to animals. It could come back to bite you.
Oliver Stone died in 1988.